Hello and welcome back to my channel. My name is Nicole Huseman and I'm so excited today to be showing y'all my Nordstrom Trunk Club review. I will be showing you everything that the stylist at Nordstrom thought that I would like, as well as the outfits they put together for me. So let's dive into this. I'm super excited. Everything will be linked down below, so if you want to twin with me, you totally can. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button so we can be friends. Go ahead and hit that bell icon and it'll just let you know whenever I upload a new video, which is Mondays and Thursdays at 4 p.m. Pacific time. Also, please give this video a thumbs up. It really helps me out as a small content creator. And without further ado, let's dive in. So the Nordstrom Trunk Club is pretty unique in that it's a styling service that picks out outfits for you, sends them to you, but it's everything from Nordstrom. So I find it's a little bit more my style than say like Stitch Fix, which I tried and they actually never sent me anything. I was gonna do a video on them too and they just refunded me. This is my second trunk from Nordstrom Trunk Club. The first trunk was seriously perfect. As soon as I got it, I was obsessed with the outfits they planned and I immediately scheduled my next box and I thought it'd be really fun to show y'all this box, show y'all what I got. It is $25 for the initial box, but that $25 can apply to anything that you end up buying. So if you end up buying at least one or two items from the box, it is essentially a free service. And you get like 7 to 8 items dependent on what you tell your stylist you're looking for. You might get all shoes if you say you want all shoes. I asked for a good mix of things. I told them my style was very girly, white, pinks, cream. I love brands like Reformation and River Island. And so far I've been really pleased with the pieces they pick. You do get to preview the box before it comes. And so if anything isn't quite to your liking, you can just remove it from their box and they'll replace it with something else that you think you'll like more. So I normally replace maybe like 2 out of 10 items per box and I'm really excited to see what they replaced it with. And I will go ahead and first show y'all everything they got me. And then I'll show you the outfits that they styled together. They do send you outfit recommendations for how the pieces can all fit together. So it's a really cool like capsule wardrobe in a box. The box actually looks like a trunk, which is really nice. And I'm just a huge fan of this. This video is not sponsored in any way, shape or form. I do have a referral link. So if you want to get $50 off your first purchase, please use my link down below, but I'm not affiliated with Nordstrom. I just really love this service and it's how I've been shopping for all my clothes recently. So let's dive into the clothes, then we'll show you the outfits, and at the end, I'll give you my final review of this trunk. The first thing I got from my box is this Kurt Geiger camel sort of like knit purse, and I am obsessed with this. I am getting such high-end vibes. This retails for $265, which is about what I would pay for a purse. Truthfully, I would pay a little bit more, but normally I do like to pick my own purses out. However, I am very strongly considering keeping this. I think it is just so gorgeous to have a mid-size bag in this color. I love the bird detail that's on top. And then I'm not gonna unpackage it too much because if I decide I do wanna send it back, I'm hoping they can, I don't wanna like take this completely apart. But it does have lots of room inside. I really like this chain with a leather strap on the top so it's not like gonna dig into your shoulder. And I really am getting like Chanel vibes from this. Yeah, so this is the first item. I think there's actually a lot of, there's 3 different purses in here. So this trunk might be a little purse heavy, but I love purses, so I'm totally fine with that. Next up is this denim skirt from River Island. And this retails for $65. It has a cool double waistband, so I'm really excited to try this out. I don't always love how denim skirts look on me, so I'm not sure, but I did see the double waistband and thought it was a really cool version of a denim skirt if I am gonna wear one. So I thought this would be a little bit out of my comfort zone style-wise. Next up is this floral bodysuit by Aster. It retails for $58. And I really like this floral print. I'm hoping it's not too grandma-y on. I think this paired with maybe a mini skirt would look really cute. I really like that this bodysuit is mesh on the bottom. I feel like that's gonna be a little bit more comfortable to wear than when the material goes all the way down. But I am really curious to see how this fits because I think this is gonna be a piece that you really have to try on to see if it's flattering or not. Another piece from ASTR or Aster is this white ruched top, and this retails for $35.40, so a little bit cheaper than the bodysuit. Again, I think this is gonna be something I really want to try on, but it is definitely in my style. This is something that I don't know if I would have picked out in the store, but I'm very happy it came in my box because I really want to try it on. I loved the ruching on the back, as well as these interesting sleeves. and I'm pumped to see how they're gonna style this one. Next up is this tiered chiffon mini skirt from River Island, and this retails for $30. I really like it, but I'm not always a fan of how the ruched skirts, like right around my tummy, fit me. I think it makes it really hard to eat anything, but I do love the colors. I'm a big River Island fan, and it is actually from River Island's resort collection, which I am a huge fan of. I own a couple pieces from it, and it's really great for the summers and for holidays. So I'm really excited to try this on. I'm pretty sure it's gonna go with the white ruffled shirt, and I'm pumped to see how those two look together. Next, we have another bag, and this is very much on the higher end. This is a Saint Laurent clutch, and this was actually something I added on as an add-on item. This wasn't picked for me because I think I said I only wanted purses in the like $200 to $500 price range, because anything above that is something that I want to be thinking about for a long time and pick out. But I did see this and I am so excited. I think this is the piece I was most excited for it to come. It comes in a box with a authenticity card, and like I said with the other purse, I'm not gonna unbox it too much because I do want the ability to send it back. But it comes in this dust bag. I'll just pull it out. Oh. It is this quilted Saint Laurent clutch, and this retails, I think I said, for $725, and it comes with a strap. For some reason, I thought this was like a crossbody bag, so let's see, there's no strap inside, but it is a small purse. Like, it's just a clutch, so it's gorgeous. I love the quilting on it, but I do think for $725, it should have some sort of crossbody strap. So with this one, I'm not sure if it's gonna be styled into any of the outfits, because this was something I put into the box and the stylist didn't. It doesn't really match the vibe of everything, but I'll go ahead and throw it into an outfit that needs a purse, just so you guys can see what it looks like when it is styled. Next up is this ruched, it's like ruched on the side. It's a cotton blend tank top from Open Edit. This retails for $24, and I wish I could show you or like have you feel through the screen how absolutely soft this is. I'm so pumped to put this on. It feels really good. I am a little worried about how tight it's gonna be, just because I'm not a huge fan of wearing super tight things, because I like bagels. I like to eat. I wanna be able to eat a full meal and not look pregnant. And sometimes in a really tight top, I definitely look bloated. So really pumped about this, super excited to try it on. And I feel like the price point is lower than I was expecting for a top of this quality. Another item from Open Edit are these camel wide leg pants. And these retail for only $34. So again, super impressed with the price for what looks like a pretty quality piece. Like, the fabric feels really nice. I'm excited to see the construction of these on, because it is looser than I normally wear, but they have pockets, they are cuffed on the bottom, and I just think they are so exactly what I want. I don't have anything like this in my closet, so very pumped the stylist sent me this. Next up is this Tory Burch purse for $248. Not exactly sure why they sent me two camel, almost like crossbody bags, but they are pretty different. This does have the Tory Burch logo on the front. It is much smaller than the other one, much more thin, where the other one was definitely a size bag that I think I could get most of my everyday things in. This would, again, just be the essentials. I do like the pocket in the middle. It doesn't have a zipper, but then you do get two zippered pouches on either side. I do want to see how this styles with outfits, because I think it might look a little bit more stylish just being so compact. But I think between the two, I'm leaning towards the Kurt Geiger, and I have no reason to have two bags that are very similar. But I think this is great for outfits. It's very nondescript, but you do still get a little bit of that logo, and you know it's a quality made piece because Tory Burch makes great luxury goods. Next up are these Mark Fisher sandals for $150. Let's open these up. These are super trendy right now. I feel like I see them everywhere. So I'm a little worried to spend that much money on a trend-led item, but I do think they're fairly classic. They are these braided sandals with one strap. I did recently order some from Amazon that aren't the exact same. There are two braided straps with no toe thong, but they were like $30 and these are $150. So these would really, really have to blow me away in terms of comfort. Otherwise, I think I would just stick with my Amazon ones. And so that y'all can too, I'll go ahead and link those down below as well. But these, I'm sure, are gonna pair super well with everything because they fit the color theme of this entire order. Next up are these Seychelles mules. These retail for $98.95. I don't have any, if at all, mules in my closet, so these are exciting. I'm gonna have to put this down to open it. It looks like this, which I think is a gorgeous mule. I am a little concerned about the color. It's a little bit more gray, like a grayish, than more on the camel side, which is kind of what I was expecting and kind of more what I wear. But oh, they look very nice. I feel like this would be a great everyday shoe for work to wear that would easily pair with outfits and would replace me when I want to just wear my Birkenstocks, which aren't the most fashionable but are just so easy to throw on. All right, so those are all the pieces that I was sent, and now is the fun part where I get to try everything on in the outfits that they recommended and show y'all what everything fits. So I actually looked in the app and the outfits this time are not impressive to me. They kind of all look very similar. They all have the same shoe. They all have the same purse. It's kind of just like the denim mini skirt paired with all the tops. So I think that was because I replaced some items in the order, but I'm just gonna go ahead and style them how I would style the items and show you all what that looks like because So this is the first outfit that I would pair together. It is the ruche tank, the brown wild leg trousers, and then just paired with the braided Mark Fisher shoes. Starting from the top, this tank top is so soft. I love the ruching on the sides. I think it's really flattering. I will almost definitely be keeping this top. I think it is super cute, super versatile. I like the pants. I like the vibe that the pants give this outfit of kind of like flowy, tropical, like I'm going to Tulum soon and I can totally see myself wearing them. I like the bottom of the pants. There's something going on with the bottom. And then this waistband, because it's this like ruched waistband instead of a more traditional waistband, while it is really comfy, it kind of makes them look like sweatpants. So while I would want this to kind of be like a dressed up model off duty look, I think it looks a little bit more like sweatpant look, which is fine, but not the polished outfits that I like to put together. Oh, and I almost forgot about the shoes. These shoes are so comfy. I don't want to love them because I want to love the $34 pair, but they are just so comfy, so easy to put on, and I think they are super on trend right now, so I'm gonna be keeping them. I just think they're so perfect. If I were to keep it, I do think the Saint Laurent clutch looks to die for with this color scheme. I'm a big fan of black and brown together. I think this is more camel than brown, but I feel like it definitely elevates this outfit from looking just like sweatpants to looking like more chic. The next look I put together is the River Island skirt with this ruched top. Now, I love this ruched top. A couple things that I didn't notice before I put it on. The sleeves are this almost like stretchy, I don't know how to describe it. I thought it was gonna be really tight and uncomfortable, but the stretchiness of the fabric really works. It's like, it's actually pretty pleasant. Feels comfortable. There's also boning in the top, which is such a great construction element, such a great way to give it structure, while the twists of the top, I think, give it a really, really pretty just silhouette. There's something interesting about it. There's movement to the piece while there's still structure, and I'll definitely be keeping this top. I couldn't wear this to work because it's a little booby, but I really, really like it for going out, especially as we get into fall, and as I live in California, it's really never that cold, so this would be great for like one of those crisper fall nights, maybe with a pair of jeans. I would pair this with the Mark Fisher heels, and I've also paired it with the River Island skirt, which I really wanted to like. Love the color scheme, but you see how it's just like, you can see, like, you see every like dip in my belly, which is just not, I don't feel the most confident like that. So I would much rather wear something more flared that adds a little bit more volume to the hips too, to kind of give that exaggerated hourglass figure. The bag I would wear it with is the Tory Burch smaller bag, and I do think, again, I don't want to like undo it too much because I want to be able to send it back. I think this is so cute of an outfit. I am now leaning more towards the Tory Burch than the Kurt Geiger because of how like compact it is, but I'm just so on the fence. So leave a comment down below, which one should I keep, the Kurt Geiger or the Tory Burch, because I cannot for the life of me decide. But I'm glad it's the end. I hate everything about this. I'll be honest, I paired it with the mules because I hadn't worn them with anything else, but there was no redemption for this outfit in shoes. The top, I hate. I hate the pattern, how it looks on. It literally doesn't even fit. Like, everything else is perfectly my size, fits perfectly according to the sizes I gave. I couldn't get it up. I had to put it on like over my head and it like wouldn't snap. They're just, it's really frustrating and it makes you feel bad when clothes that you are sent like say large or say medium and they don't fit you. Like that makes you feel pretty crappy. So I'm a little bit in a bad mood because of that. Also, these clothes are not for me. I don't like them at all. They're not my style. And in that way, I'm a little grumpy. The skirt, listen, I grew up in the rural South. I don't need to relive that. Not a fan of this. I think right now, for me at my life stage, I'm 24. I can't imagine myself wearing a denim mini skirt anymore. Yeah, this whole thing is just a no for me. If I had to, I would pair it with this bag, but you'd have to pay me so much money to be caught wearing this out of the house. Wouldn't wear it, definitely sending all pieces of this item back. Overall with the trunk, I am very happy and impressed with the items I got sent. It was definitely some things that I wouldn't have picked out for myself, like the ruched tank top that I'm so excited to now be keeping, as well as the Mark Fisher sandals. So I am absolutely definitely going to be ordering another trunk. I'm so pumped. If y'all want more content like this, I don't think I would do another video, but if you want to see like an Instagram reel or a TikTok reel of what I get, don't forget to follow me at Nicole_Huseman on Instagram, as well as Nicole McGuire Huseman on TikTok. Oh my gosh. Oh, that was a lot of work. Changing for me is like a lot of work. So if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. You've made it this far. We are friends now, and friends subscribe to each other's YouTube channels. So go ahead and hit that subscribe button. And if you click that bell icon, it'll give you just a gentle little push notification whenever I upload a video on Mondays and Thursdays. I hope you have a wonderful day. If you did want to try out Nordstrom Trunk Club, don't forget to use my link in the description box down below. It'll get you $50 off your first box. So that more than covers the styling fee and $25 towards any item. And again, that $25 styling fee can be used towards an item. So if you use that link, you basically get a free $50 of clothing. So definitely give it a shot, try it out, really no harm. And I hope you have a wonderful day. Bye.